Thank you for a refreshing talk. My question is a purely academic based. You've touched on deconstructionism, and you know that Professor Tariq Ramadan was here last month, and in his book, Radically Equal, I believe he mentions deconstruction and reconstruction and proposed addition to the Maqasid. I just wanted to know your view on, do you think that we are falling into yet another trap of another ism?
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. First of all, Dr. Tariq Ramadan is a friend of mine. So if I'm critical of him, it's not as a person. So let's divorce that. This is, he's been critical of me before. We live in an age where I don't, if someone's critical of me, one of my students one time criticized me, and then he came to me after Salah and he said, do you hate me? I said, why would I hate you? He said, because I criticize you. I said, no, I love you because you criticize me. If you're sincere, you'll criticize me. But if you're a hypocrite, you will only try to please me. And this again gets to this age that we're in now. Everyone's so sensitive. So what I would say honestly is, first of all, I don't really find what Dr. Tariq Hafizullah has proposed is that radical. And I talked to him about, I don't agree with the term radical reform. Because I think radical again applies, and I don't mean this with him, but just kind of an out of control, powerful discourse, as though everything's jacked up, dude, we gotta fix it, we gotta be radical. And I'll give you an example. Dr. Ramadan proposes that fuqaha should begin to engage modern science, you know, when they make fatwa. But this is already happening. It's happened since the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when there was a dispute about Usama bin Zayd's lineage. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam actually brought a qarif, you know, someone who looked at the hands and feet of the child. That was the best DNA they had at that time, right? To determine who the father was. And Hakam. Then he ruled, and the Prophet ruled in favor of that man. Imam An-Nawi in Al-Majmu' talks about the commonly held Maliki as well as Shafi opinion about ma' al-mushammas, water that's been heated by the sun. And we consider it makruh as well as the Shafis because we said it causes leprosy. It's a long story. Okay. So what Imam An-Nawi did, I mean, Imam An-Nawi, he went to physicians in Damascus. He said, hey, does water heated by the sun actually cause leprosy? They said no. So he changed his fatwa. Most of the majma' fiqhiyya in the Muslim world now have people who are not necessarily fuqaha. In my masjid in Boston, I'm not saying this to toot my own horn, the first week I was there, I had a case of sexual abuse. A young person who was not from Boston, by the way. So Boston people watch this, don't get mad at me. They're not from Boston, and yes, it was because of the Celtics. You know, from Mankana Tijuratuli Celtics, you know. So what I decided to do, I had a young person who was being sexually abused, and I said to them, I mentioned it earlier, I'm not equipped to handle the situation. I'm an imam from Azhar. I don't know how to deal with this. This is some dark stuff, man. So we created a coalition of 40 physicians who work with me, man. And I have a referral system in my office where people come to me. And if they are having serious marital issues or serious mental issues or issues that require therapy, I don't do it, man. I refer them to them. So I don't see that as that radical. Secondly, when it comes to Maqasid Sharia, we need to be really, really careful about talking about the Maqasid. In Azhar, the last thing you study in the College of Sharia is Maqasid. Because someone who has not studied a madhhab from A to Z, and studied the Nusus. What I mean by Nusus here are explicit legal texts, should not talk about Maqasid. Because Maqasid is a synonym for Ijtihad. The only time a faqih employs Maqasid Sharia is when there is no text. Or someone is about to die. So someone has to eat pork, for example, to live, we invoke Maqasid Sharia. Someone who has to use some type of stimulant that may be forbidden by Islam because it's a narcotic, we invoke Maqasid Sharia in front of a nas. Those, what Shatibi talked about, Al-Hijjiyat, Wa-Durriyat. And people don't know what this is I'm talking about, don't worry about it, it's a complicated issue. But it's an academic question, as my brother asked. So the only time, when I trained as a mufti for 2 years, I worked as a mufti in Egypt, I don't call myself mufti because I don't like that term. Because I'm scared of that. But the only time that a mufti uses Maqasid Sharia is in the absence of a text. And that has been held by the fuqaha since the time of Umar. So again, I don't think it's that radical. Now, vis-a-vis maybe the hyper-taqlidi traditionalist, then maybe what Dr. Tark is invoking is radical. Because he's saying, listen, we can't just continue to regurgitate classical opinions, and I agree with him on this. For example, the Maliki opinion that your wali can destroy a marriage if it's to a black man. How's that going to work in America, bro? We're post-Jim Crow. We're post-ML King. Malcolm X is the greatest Muslim ever in America. And he's black. You know, you're not going to go into a masjid in the hood and say, you know, the Maliki say that if you marry a black man, you can dissolve the marriage. You know, that's an issue that was related to ijtihad, which we criticize in light of maqasid. So I do agree with Dr. Tariq that the classical texts or opinions of scholars, right, that are based on ijtihad can be re-examined in light of our own ijtihad and maqasid, yes. So I agree with him on that, but I don't think it's that radical. I just think he's a genius. He's a wonderful human being. You know, if you want to know someone, you know, I like what he said, don't judge me by my grandfather. You should meet his children. Maryam, for example, his daughter. They're just incredible people. So my criticism of Dr. Tariq is not necessarily 100%, but I just don't think it's that radical. I do have a problem with making reality an usul. I do have a problem making the time frame that we live in the source of legislation. It's never been that way. The time that we live in has always colored legislation, but never been an independent source of legislation, unless it met two criterion, which is durriyat, inshallah, we can talk about that maybe another time.